Dad?
Yes, dear?
I feel like painting, but we don't have any canvases left.
Oh, okay, let's make some.
Yay! Bigger! 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 Some days, you wake up with the idea to try something bigger than you've ever done before. That's how I was feeling today, July the 1st, 2022. It was a typical bright sunny morning here in Thailand, but rain wasn't far away. The rainy or monsoon season in Thailand starts usually in July and lasts until October. But I've noticed each year it's a bit different. When I told Dad, I felt like painting a picture. I knew he was in for a surprise. I love drawing and painting big pictures, as it's so much fun. My idea was to paint my favorite subject, dragons, as big as possible. But just how big was possible? I wanted to find out. A few months ago, Dad made me a lot of canvas chassis. Just one of them alone is really big. The width of the biggest roll of canvas we can buy in Bangkok. I wondered, what would happen if we put two of these big canvases side by side? And then I thought, what would happen if we put four together? Would four be possible? Well, there was just one way to find out. Dad and I finished cutting four pieces of cotton canvas to fit the chassis, and we rolled them up. The puppies were very playful and curious about what we were up to. They would suddenly flop down and go to sleep in the most unusual of positions. We have five dogs of our own. They are in the house. These puppies in our driveway aren't ours. They belong to our neighbors next door. They also have a big dog called Lucky. As they work from early morning and get home really late every day, we offered to take care of the dogs each day as they were a bit lonely on their own and like company. Our neighbors found these puppies living on the street without a home near to where they work. They felt sorry for them and brought them home. So we have a neighborly dog share going on at the moment. The trouble is, just right now, our own dogs don't like them at all. They will eventually, but it will take some time. Maybe the time it takes to paint my dragon picture. Now it's time to stretch the canvas over the chassis. Ideally, the canvases should be stretched as tight as a drum, which is quite hard to do with just your fingers, but Dad is used to doing it. It's really hot and humid in Thailand. Although Dad has lived here for many, many years, he still hasn't got used to the tropical weather. As the ceilings indoors are too low to paint a picture as big as this, the best place to paint it was our driveway. Here's our friend Chin. He does building jobs for local people after work. To paint such a big picture, made out of four separate canvases together, all at once, they needed to be joined in some way. We had to cut out part of our garden wall. Dad said, if I have such a big dream, whether it's to paint a picture or something else, I shouldn't dream it any smaller just to make it easier. And promise my painting wasn't going to be 1 millimeter smaller than I dreamed it to be. The frame was so big, we had to cut down some branches from our tree and take off part of an awning above a bedroom window. Also, we needed to plan for a sudden change in weather. The four canvases together needed to be strong to withstand the sudden gusts of wind and easy to unscrew if it suddenly started to rain. I couldn't believe my eyes that evening when I saw all four canvases put together to make just one. And the canvases had to be taken down for the night. Chin came by the next day to finish a few things. Drawing and painting at the bottom and middle wasn't going to be so difficult. I've done that before. The next challenge was to find a way to work safely at the very top. To get to the top of the canvas, Dad said we needed scaffolding. Mom looked online and found a company that rented what we needed by the week. I've never climbed that high before, and I wondered how all the pieces fitted together. It looked kind of exciting. Dad and Mum started to put the scaffolding together. Chin came by unexpectedly, but just at the right time, as Chin's been putting scaffolding together all his life. Although the design of the scaffolding was pretty standard, we needed to add something to it of our own to make it even safer for me to be up that high. We already have a painting scaffolding of our own. It just needed a few changes. Chin added one extra bar to the legs so I could climb up and down. I was excited to start my dragon picture. And as the weather was good the next morning, Dad and Mum put the canvases together. Our plan was to take off the canvases if a storm was approaching. Feeling so happy as the time had come to start my dragon painting adventure. I guess there are two ways to do a painting like this. Make a design first in your studio, and if you like it, you copy it onto the canvas. Or the other way is to just draw something without any plan and see what happens. This is the way I like best. I have no idea at all what the painting will look like right now. All I know is it's going to be about dragons, as I love them so much. Actually, the first toy my dad bought me was just after I was born, from a stall by the Japria River, near the hospital in Bangkok. In a corner, tucked away, was a little black soft toy. Dad spied it and thought it was a bat, and he chose that toy for me. The stall owner thought he was crazy to buy such an ugly looking thing. So, on my first day of life, I had this little toy next to me. And some years later, I discovered it wasn't a bat, but in fact a dragon. Not just any dragon, it was Toothless from the film How to Train Your Dragon. To this day, 7 years later, this little Toothless is still my favorite toy. and I think it's beautiful. I felt very safe at the top of the scaffolding, as I had an extra guardrail around me so I couldn't fall. When the sun came around in the afternoon, Dad made a shade with a sheet of canvas so I wasn't too hot. In the early afternoon, I stopped drawing for the day. I had the best time ever. At the end of the day, the canvases were brought into the house in case it rained overnight, and screwed back on again in the morning. I was excited to try and finish my drawing. The weather was fine, so I just carried on where I left off yesterday. Our neighbors drop off the puppies at 7 a.m. each day when they go to work. We also have 7 turtles, which were either just given to us as unwanted pets, or wandered into the house from the swamp and just stayed. We've had them for over 15 years. It was an extremely hot and humid day, so Dad put the scaffolding close by with a sheet of canvas to block out the sun, and I was able to finish my drawing. In the design, I have a mixture of big dragons, medium and small. There is no real up or down in the picture. It's more of a pattern. But at the bottom of the canvas, my dragons are resting in the flowers on a hot day, just like today. The weather has been kind to us, considering it's the rainy season. Dad and Mom put the canvases together in the morning so I could start the underpainting as my drawing was finished. I like using acrylic paints best. They dilute with water and dry fast. One way of making a painting is to imagine a main color for the picture. For some reason, I was in the mood for shades of blue. On the color wheel, on the right side of blue is green, on the left side, violet. As these colors are neighbors, they will harmonize very well with blue. The canvases are brought in every night and brought out the next morning. As we are a homeschooling family, I have some subjects that are fixed, which I do each day, and some free time in the morning and the afternoon to choose an activity I want to do most, which is always drawing and painting. But it's up to me, it could be anything. I have a tutor called Pibla. She's a photo editor for a magazine, and she lives close by. Pibla teaches me Thai reading and writing. Today I have a Thai language lesson. Pibla is a very creative teacher and always makes beautiful looking things to help me remember my lessons. It's the next day, and I started painting the top of my picture after breakfast until Pibla came to our house to give me another Thai lesson. Today, Pibla surprised me with a game she invented with words written on paper hidden in eggs. It was a lot of fun. After my Thai lesson, the weather was still good. Really hot. One of those super hot days, you need a fan close by so as not to melt like an ice cream in the sun. Our neighbor's puppies just chill out in the shade. The following day was the time to add the complementary color to blue, orange. Just in small amounts, so the blue would always stay the main color. The paint is really thin up to now, a little bit like watercolor. As I just wanted to know what the painting would look like with these colors before I put on the detail. I worked most of the hot afternoon. I was hoping the weather would be kind, as I still had lots to do at the top of the painting. The next day, I wanted to work at the top, so Dad and Mom set up the scaffolding and the extra guardrail at the top. In my last painting, I got used to climbing ladders. And although this is a much bigger picture than I've done before, I found I actually liked being up there at the top the best. I guess it feels a bit like being in a treehouse. Today, I had another Thai lesson with Pipa. And in the afternoon, I was finally able to finish the main part of the underpainting at the top. As luck would have it, I managed to get this far in the picture before the monsoon rain arrived. Our plan B went into action, and we lifted all four canvases over the balcony and into my studio. A delivery motorbike came by our house with a mysterious parcel for me. Dad and Mum surprised me with my very own dragon wings, tail and mask. I was super happy. It rained a lot, and I was happy to be cozy inside and had my Thai lesson with Pibla as usual. My parents rented the scaffolding 2 weeks ago. And today was the day it had to go back. No worries, as I could finish the details on my painting indoors. Dad starts practicing piano around 5 a.m. with the silent practice pedal down. Just after breakfast, I have a 30-minute music lesson. We improvise together at the piano, I learn how to read music, and we sing songs together. We also make music as a family. Mum plays electric guitar. I play drums. Mum teaches me chords on the guitar, the Thai flute, and also the kim. And we sing lots of songs with just the guitar too. Dad teaches me English language, reading and writing. We read together for about an hour each day. Mum likes to teach me maths. Maths is one of my favorite subjects. I learn Photoshop, edit videos, make animations, and make voiceovers for videos such as this. We do science experiments such as make a clock work with two apples. Painting makes me feel happy. Always makes me feel like dancing and jumping about. to make the brush strokes and colors connect together in my painting. When I come to the edges, we put two canvases together. There's enough space in my studio to put two side by side. We clamp the canvases together so they don't move about. And I can work on the details each day in between my lessons. Our neighbor's puppies are really active, then fall asleep. Our own five dogs don't get along with them yet, so we're introducing them together slowly. Our dogs are good house dogs, are very friendly, and like to have human company. The good thing is, they get on well together, too. I like making textures by painting and rubbing around with a cloth and going over and over. Because the canvas is white, the colors look brightest when the paint is quite thin. Around 5 o'clock, most days, I play with my friends. Sometimes we play traffic lights and road safety on our bikes at the top of our street. My favorite late afternoon snack is apple. And tonight I'm drinking my science experiment. Delicious! In between my lessons and playing with friends, I kept on painting my picture, as usual, day after day, until it was finally finished. To do this, we sometimes put the canvases side by side on the easel so I can make sure the edges blended together between the two canvases and sides. I use the same style for this picture as in my previous paintings. Sometimes the outlines of the dragons are shaded on the outside to make them stand out, and sometimes on the inside. It depends on the color of the background. This painting is a high key painting, so there's no really dark colors, just the eyes, I guess. The painting goes from light to middle tones, and that's it. Maybe I'll paint a low key painting next, from middle to dark tones. I thought of calling the painting, It's Summer for Dragons. I was really curious to know what the four canvases put together would look like. Dad said he woke up with an idea and invited us to go for a little walk to see our neighbor. The rain had stopped and it was sunny again. Dad wanted to give me a surprise. He asked me, since I like drawing and painting so much, ever since I was 1 year old, would I like to have an exhibition? Wow, I never expected that. But yes, I was really excited by the idea. Our neighbor, Ah, has a building. He used to let a clothing factory use. They went away, and now it's a car park during the week. At the weekends, it's empty. Dad asked Ah if we could have an exhibition there the following Sunday. He said yes. We found lots of sheets of old plywood left behind by the clothing factory. Ah said we could use them to make them into exhibition boards. All they really needed were legs and a lick of paint to smarten them up. This is Yui. He's a picture framer. We had a design for a type of framing wood, which Yui made for us out of soft wood used in building construction. It wasn't so expensive to make, and we were able to frame all my medium-sized paintings with it. On the top floor of our home, we have a printing room. We can print our own pictures up to 24 inches wide. Over the past few years, I've made lots of graphic type pictures. Mostly, I draw the outlines on paper, scan, color in Photoshop, then print. I especially like the bright colors you can get. Sometimes I mix the coloring stage with pencil crayons and watercolor too, before I scan, which gives another type of coloring effect in Photoshop. We have lots of frames of different sizes, so I can make my prints fit these frames. We can reuse these frames over and over if we make more exhibitions in the future. We had lots of pictures to finish, and somehow over the week, we managed to get all the paintings and prints ready for hanging on the Saturday. Chin cut the wood to make legs for the boards each day after 6 o'clock when all the cars had gone home. After a few evenings, we had enough panels to fill the whole room. Dad said we needed a poster to hang outside the exhibition to let people know they were in the right place when they arrived by car from far away. I'd never made a poster before, and it looked like it was going to be a lot of fun to do. Dad said it was useful for an artist to know how to make posters and lettering, and I wanted him to teach me. We took the poster over to our building and hung it on the fence. As there were no cars in our building at the weekend, Saturday was the first big day we had to put the exhibition together. We asked our piano movers to help too. They have a van and are super careful with everything they carry. Chin finished off painting the panels, and bit by bit, all the paintings from my studio were lifted over the balcony and taken just around the corner. We had many trips. Dad said it would be good for me to have an exhibition, as I could see most of what I painted from 1 year old to today, all together, side by side. And also discover what it feels like to show my pictures to people in the way a musician enjoys playing to a live audience. Our friend Tak said she liked to sing at my exhibition. That was a lovely surprise. I got to see the four canvases of my big dragon picture together again. By coincidence, the space for that picture was perfect. We couldn't really have had the exhibition anywhere else, as it's hard to find a place with such a high ceiling. And there seemed to be just the right amount of white panels. And suddenly, everything started to take shape. Around 2:30 Sunday afternoon, our friends and neighbors started arriving at the exhibition. Mum served lots of different fruit juice drinks with cookies and ice cream. Then I had the nicest of surprises as my Uncle David and his wife Tong Te and their friends came too. They travelled very far indeed. I gave David a tour of all my pictures and he asked many questions about everything. That was so kind of him to be interested. The things I've enjoyed making most of all so far have been pen and pencil drawings, acrylic paintings, and graphic art in Photoshop, which we print out ourselves. My best friend Gao came with his father Ju, and I had the biggest honor as David and Tong Te unveiled my big dragon painting.
Wow.
I never expected that. Thank you so very much. Our friends Perita and Hugh came too. They'd just returned from the north of Thailand. Around 5:30, 6 o'clock, people started to head back home. This exhibition was the most awesome day ever. As my exhibition had been on a Sunday afternoon, the room needed to return to a car park early morning the next day. So the whole room was cleared that evening. Our neighbors with the puppies helped us a lot. They have a truck, which made things a lot easier. The big paintings stayed in the room out of the way overnight. And after the cars had gone away the next day, Dad carried them home one by one. Chin came by to fix the wall and get the window awning working again. As night fell, everything we'd taken to the exhibition was back home again. Our friend Tak stayed with us all Monday and we celebrated her birthday, which had been a few weeks before. On Tuesday morning, we passed all the paintings that had been stored downstairs the night before up and over the balcony and we put them back in my studio again. I had a nice feeling and discovered all that goes into making an exhibition. I guess I learned a lot from this nice experience. One of the things I learned is how kind people can be when you organize something and they see you need help. One of the best parts of the afternoon was being together with our friends and how they all insisted they help us at the end of the day. It felt wonderful to have my painting unveiled by David and Tong Te. I never imagined such a thing could happen. The day was also a lot of fun. It was nice to see people coming together again. Life is getting back to normal at last. On the subject of back to normal, the Red Cross compound next to our house has been closed for more than 2 years. In the past, local people liked to exercise here. Kids played together. It finally reopened the other day too. So, another thing to be happy about. Mum is always sketching animals. She is a wildlife artist. always drawing our dogs, and now the puppies. And our cat Pepper, of course. I continue my Thai lessons as usual with Pipla, and Mum and I read books in Thai together each day. During the time it took to paint my picture, our five dogs and the puppies would not get along at all. But over the past month, they saw each other through the glass doors every day, so kind of got used to each other. We thought it was time for them to finally meet face to face. There was a bit of grumpiness at first, but phew, no fights. The puppies have grown up a lot in just 1 month. And each day we continue to look after the puppies and take them back when we hear our neighbors are home again.
Dad, I feel like painting another big picture, but we don't have any canvases left.
Okay, let's make some.
Yay! Also, now that our dogs and the puppies are friends, can the frame be a little bit smaller so they can pass through and hang out together?
Great idea! Let's do it!
Yay!
After some measuring, we decided a good size for my next painting to fit the available space was 3 meters by 2.50 meters. Chin set to work, cut the frame down to size, and welded it again. It's the same shape as my big painting, just proportionally smaller. Dad made 8 wooden canvas chassis, 1.50 meter by 1.25 meter, in case I wanted to do 2 big paintings. And we put the canvas on 4 of them. Today, the dogs are even more friendly to each other than yesterday. And even our cat Pepper is getting along with the puppies. Looking at these new canvases, they're actually a really nice size. The chassis fit the width of the canvas roll, so nothing is really wasted. Next, we tested the size of the new metal frame, and it just fitted perfectly. And I was looking forward to starting the new painting. For the moment, I just made a dot with my pen. That's kind of a start, isn't it? As everything fitted perfectly, as hoped, we brought the canvases in for the night. Now that all the dogs accept each other, we decided to take our neighbor's dog, Lucky, and the two puppies, with our 5 dogs, for their first ever walk in nature at the back of our house. Over the months, we planted banana trees and made a pathway so the dogs can have some freedom in total safety away from cars. For their first walk together, didn't go so badly. The dogs seem to love the smell of mud and grass. And after a few walks together up and down, all the dogs were tired in the heat and just relaxed together as a big family. Here are a few details from It's Summer for Dragons. It wasn't just a painting to me. It felt more like an adventure. I discovered you can have a big adventure just staying at home. Painting dragons, fireflies, Flying dinosaurs, glowing bees and butterflies. On such a big canvas, without any plan, felt like an adventure. Bright colors are magical. They make me feel like dancing. And I love that feeling. This past month was a happy summer dragon adventure. I'll never forget. Also, it feels very special to share this painting adventure with you. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.